Hello and welcome to Channel Sports on Sunday. I am Ken Ochonogo. Today is stacked. This program is going to be choked. And I tell you, I want to make sure that before we sign off, you'll be smiling. You are going to follow us all the way. Nigeria is 60, yeah, and October is the 60th month. We'll do some celebrations. I know you've been trying to say who is the best sportsman, who is the best administrator, what is the best achievement, what is your best moment. Some of you were not born in 60 years ago. Of course, you read them. And what are the high points that it has been? But then history, our past is great. And the purpose of the foundation is to lay the edifice. And the foundation has to be strong enough to carry that superstructure. So we're... A lot of fine points, a lot of achievements, anywhere you are in the world, there is no way you mention Nigeria, that, or you talk about sports, that you won't talk about Nigeria. So we've made our marks in Africa, in everything you can think of. We've done that in boxing, we've done that in wrestling, we've done that in football, we've done that in many, many, many other sports. We've dominated the world, and in the world of fisticuffs these days, of course, starting from Hogan, Kitbazi, Dick Tiger, we went to the Olympic Games and others. We've been at the Olympics. No, who can forget Noji Mayegu? You can't do that. And then in wrestling, of course, today we are going to talk a lot of wrestling. But then I remember in the 70s and the 80s, it was the era of Power Mike. Do you remember Power Mike? Mike Bamidele, you remember? There was Power Uti, a lot of them did us proud. Killing Machuku, the guy will hold his teeth and pull the drag and said yes. Wrestling was all fun. And then we remember all those things when you tune on the telly and hear what is his name that time? Okogan and the rest of them all. So we'll do that. But then at the end of the day, we ask ourselves, whatever, there is a reason why you do things, the career path. If you choose what you want to do, will you be able to earn a living? Will you be able to create an impact, not just, a social impact, but, financial stability, that you can take care of yourself, your family, your children at the end of the day, that it is not just a vocation, that it's not just, for what you love, but at least this is where you say, yes, I love my heart and I get from it. So we'll talk a lot of that. Of course, you can't run away from me that the major thing happening right now is tennis, and that is the Tennis World Cup. I like tennis because they have four World Cups, unlike football and other things. And you have the Australian Open, you have the French Open, you have Wimbledon, and you have the US Open. But this year, Wimbledon are the apex one, and one will not be taking place. But the French Open, the guys on clay, that slow court, is taking place now. At the men's area, it looks a bit stable because they want to pursue history, and nobody wants to go there. But for Serena Williams and some other ladies, I mean, it's becoming a bridge too far. We shall look at what is happening. Yemi just informed me just now that Halep has been knocked out. I said, wow. She's one of those persons, because of her intensity, we thought we'd get over there. So we'll look at that. We also go around and look at, our football. We're going to talk a lot of football too, but not in the sense of how we're going to do it in the leagues and the rest of it all. The Champions League, it is going to be Ronaldo taking on Messi. And people said it is fixed. I don't know how they fix these things. Is it when the balls are hot or when the balls are cold? But then they are in the same group in the UEFA Champions League. And a lot of honorary Didier Drogba, who has been honored by UEFA president, picking that award. I tell you this, the guy said, it is not what I did on the pitch of play. I am more proud of what I have become in the past 20 years. So he tells that he's not a man, and that is what he used the pedestal, what he used that opportunity to achieve, which is what is important. And remember the music by the late Sonny Okosu, From Cape Town to Cairo. Yes, it has happened, From Cape Town to Cairo. And I tell you this, because somebody, Kitsu, the man who is coaching Mamelodi Sundowns, is leaving, okay, he has left South Africa. And he's coaching Al Ahly, the team of the century. And I tell you this, write it down. Punch your calculator, because the guy goes home with $120,000 a month. That is how much he's earning. And even the president of South Africa said, I acknowledge you, because that is what you've done for us. So a lot of all this, we shall come to you at the transfer. Edinson Cavani, 33-year-old. Is that where Manchester United has landed? I don't know where that is happening. We thought Barcelona were going topsy-turvy, bet two games out of two, and they've got that. The Suarez have left them, and that is why we start the show before we join, before we go to Yenegua to get this interview done. Let me call on Yemi, because Yemi is in the house. Yemi, you are welcome to the show.
Good afternoon, Ken. Good afternoon, Vias. Like you have said, Simona Halep has just been sent crashing out of the French Open, the Roland Garros. And these new generation players, they're not even millennials. They call them Generation Z.
Generation Z.
Because people like us can refer to ourselves as millennials. Okay, we wrote probably WAEC.
Yes.
I'm sure you wrote WASC. Some wrote NECO.
Yeah. No. I didn't do GSS 1, GSS 3.
I'm sure.
I did class 1 to 5.
And you did from 5.
Yes.
We don't belong to the same generation.
Yes, we don't belong to the same generation.
The way our generation is taking out your generation, okay, let's put it that way.
Yes.
I think the Roland Garros coming back to that particular tournament is really giving us the kind of excitement we want. We can see the likes of Nadal and Djokovic still making a good progress. But the Polish 19-year-old girl sending 2018 champion
Simona
Halep out of it, I think is a good one. And we're hoping to have a great show.
We are hoping to have a great show. And when you look between myself and Yemi, yes, we have, Caesar is in the house. I call him Caesar Augustus Ikenwa. He came all the way, he left Ilorin all the way this morning and got down to Lagos and said, I have to be on this show. He is the chairman of Kwara State Wrestling Association, Augustus Caesar Ikenwa. You're welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. How are you doing?
Fine. Wrestling in Kwara. Augustus, how is it like in Kwara now? How is it like? How is the wrestling in Kwara? I don't want to ask you where you want to go to, but how is it? What is the state of wrestling in Kwara now? And why? How come you are? How did you become the chairman of the association?
Well, let's start with the state of wrestling now.
Yes,
it's on a trajectory and it's looking up.
It's looking up.
Very, very up.
So where has it been? Where has it been?
It's been a bit silent, but you know, when you embark on a developmental program, it takes time for you to harness resources you have and then build on a blueprint. The government has come out with a blueprint for sports. The Wrestling Association itself has developed one to key in with what the government has put in place, and we're taking the milestones as they come, and we'll get there.
Okay, I know where you were. Okay, I think we have origin and destination. You understand? Origin actually is okay. Fine. How is it now? You know, at what state have you found it? I mean, what are the things on ground? What are the people? What are the people on ground? What is the talent on ground? What are what the coaches on ground?
We have exciting talent.
So in terms of those areas now, do you have facilitators? Do you have coaches? Do you have equipment? Do you have the mats? Do you have how spread is it? Is it Ilorin as Kwara or Kwara as Kwara?
No, as Kwara as Kwara.
Yes.
You know, all the Finn local governments are covered. The five emirates in Ilorin are covered.
Okay.
You know, what we had to sit down and not to take a rush approach to it. Because we're not just looking at the National Sports Festival coming up. We're looking at 2 years from now, 4 years from now, 6 years from now,
okay,
groom those athletes to become Olympic athletes.
Okay.
Now, in order to, wrestling basically at this level is Greco-Roman and freestyle,
okay,
you know. For the sports festival, will be our first outing competitively with those wrestlers. We've put in a three-pronged approach towards our developmental program,
okay,
and that is basically, one, equipment and facilities.
All right.
In the three major hubs,
okay,
in Kwara State, the three central zones, all the emirate, the five emirate areas in Ilorin Township, to a health and insurance scheme.
Okay.
Where what we have in place now is that if our wrestlers have a slight headache, they don't have to bother about spending their money for treatment. There's an HMO that we're working with. They will take care of that up till surgeries.
Okay.
So that has been put in place.
Uh-huh.
It kicked off this month.
Okay.
And then we have diet. It's very, very important for every wrestler. You must feed well. You must feed right. In that respect, every month we have a welfare package that will send down to the wrestlers. They come and pick it up. That package includes dry rations and all the smaller fees to supplement what they eat, so that we groom them right with their diet. They have the facilities that we're going to put in place. The facilities are not in place yet.
Okay.
Because of the cost of it. I mean, wrestling mats is not like, say, if I want to build a football pitch, you know, I cut, I trim, I get florists to help put the design in place. 130 by 90 yards, fantastic. But for wrestling, the mats alone, the cheapest we've been able to source right now is about 8 million naira.
Okay.
You know, and it's quite expensive. So, and, you know, government cannot do everything. The Honorable Commissioner, she has been fantastic going around the stage. She just finished the tournament in Ilorin, table tennis tournament.
All right.
What I'm trying to lay out is the fact that she is attending to every sport and attending to every detail concerning the sports and what they desire.
Okay, we'll also see if it is possible for us to go straight, if we are ready, if we can go straight to Yenegoa, because I'm told that we have the Dynamite Online, the Kid Star. He is the president of Nigerian Wrestling Federation. He is he was a member of the House of Assembly in Bayelsa State. He is also a two-time, yes, I tell you this, a back-to-back, in sport we say back-to-back, back-to-back commissioner for sport and youth development in Bayelsa State, Honorable Daniel Igali. Hello, Dan, how are you?
I'm doing very well, and I want to thank you for having me on your show today.
Okay. Daniel, let us look at... I remember most of what I read that... I know you also read that literature book. You are widely read. Daniel has come to judgment. this is part two. Let us, because, you know, having you is fun because, you know, because of the things you've done and the things you want to do, and it's always fun talking with you. But let's look at Bayelsa. You have done one term in Bayelsa, you understand? And you are back as the commissioner for youth and sport. In your first term, what did you meet on the ground? Where have you taken it to? And where do you hope to build it to in your second term?
Okay, well, in my first term, you know, we were at the dying embers of government. So I essentially came in to ensure that everything stayed in place before I left. So I can't say we did very much. You know, when a government is leaving and there's seemingly another government coming in place, things don't move as you would otherwise expect. So what I did was not much. But we're now in a new government. And we've started the process of ensuring that we start relying, or actually putting a lot more emphasis on our long-term athlete development projects. So all the coaches are in line. We've drawn out that framework. Just very similar to what Kenwa was saying there, we are looking at the next athletes that will take over from the athletes at the elite level now. So we're relying on the school age to the cadet, to the juniors, and then the seniors. And that's a long-term project for the basic level, because that's about the biggest problem we have with a lot of sporting associations in Nigeria. That said, we also have to look at the immediate, which is the sports festival. So we're ramping up preparations for the sports festival. We're looking at training and retraining of our coaches, referees, and athletes, because that is the part that I think we miss the most times. Okay. The sports politics part of it is what we don't do enough. So those are things we're doing right now.
Okay, I love the idea of training and retraining, and you can see that. Yes, I hope other sports are not jealous, because today we are having wrestling at the center, we are having wrestling at the grassroots, and it's all there. And you are synergizing with Augustus Ikenwa, who is also here. Let us. I still want to remain in Bayelsa. How important and how challenging has it been in putting facilities? I understand the terrain, the Bayelsa terrain. Bayelsa might look at one of the small state in landmass area, but in moving from one area to the other, you know, means of transportation, access, and other things, I know there are a lot of challenges. How have you been able to say, okay, fine, you want to leave your Negua, get to Pokuma, you want to leave there, get to Sagbama, get to other areas, and see how you can touch the grassroots, put the facilities and the trainers that you want to train in those areas?
Very challenging. I think, first and foremost, the luck I have is I have a governor who was a former commissioner for youth and sports development.
Okay.
His Excellency is Senator Doyedri. So there's that attention for sports, and I'm happy a lot of the discussions we've had has been very progressive. That said, the area of terrain is a challenge for the riverine areas, and Bayelsa is key. We have 8 local government areas. What we've tried to do is to ensure that we send coaches to a lot of the local government areas so that we can develop talent and bring them to Yenagoa to be nurtured. The other policy that I put in place now in the Sports Council is that if coaches are very productive in their local government areas, and for instance, we're going to the sports festival, and a coach has been able to produce a sizable number of athletes for the team, then that person goes as one of the coaches to the sports festival.
Okay.
That has not been happening, so there was a lot of low morale because most of the coaches on the sports council are the ones that are always traveling. So it doesn't matter how many athletes you discover and bring to the team, as long as you're in the local governments, you're not traveling. So everybody wants to be in the center. So those are the things that we're trying to change. Facility development is obviously a priority for us. It's going to take time. I mean, it's not something we'll get in a year. We're looking at putting facilities gradually over the next 4 and likely 8 years. Hopefully, when we do that, we'll be able to have solved some of it. Obviously, we're not going to be able to do all, but we would have solved a sizable portion of it.
Okay, let's come to your primary constituency. I know you are a man of the people. Augustus is here. I'm having fun anyway because I have to be shooting the way I want to shoot here today. And you know, Yemi is also here, so you also have one or two things to add in. I want us to come in from one particular sport. He's also watching there, Augustus. Wrestling, table tennis. Yeah. Of course, table tennis and other things. If you move out of the realm of football. If you move out of the realm of boxing and maybe athletics to an extent, how will somebody say, okay, I'm a wrestler and I should be able to make a living out of, you know, after your amateur wrestling? Because you can go and play professional football. We've just talked about Kitsu now, you know, earning $120,000 for just a month for coaching. I mean, what will inspire people to say, I want to be a wrestler? Because after this, I can take care of myself and my family.
Well, like the Honorable President mentioned, you see, it's developmental. After a period of time, right, the sport will be able to have equity built around it. What you have with the EPL, the Premiership, is equity they've built around it as against what you have nationally with the National League, you know, the Professional League in Nigeria. That equity will be built as against 4-5 year plan is what will pick the average wrestler now into earning lots of money later in life.
Where will he earn it? Because like I said, there is no professional. Does he want to go into
entertainment wrestling?
Exactly, which is not in existent in Nigeria.
What I'm saying is,
yes,
if that excitement is built from now over time, you catch the kids young. You groom them. It's just like the pointer the Federation president said.
That
we have borrowed from his plans.
Okay.
Right? I'm in contact with him on a regular basis.
Yeah.
What we want to do is, over time, build them up educationally, build them up in terms of facilities and all.
Yeah.
So when it now gets to a point where it becomes entertainment wrestling, you can actually hold on to something because you'll be able to build equity around the sport. So the different facets of the sport will kick in naturally.
Okay.
You know, so we're very lucky. We have Daniel Gali as president.
I'm going back to him. We're going back to Daniel. Hello, hello, Dan. We're coming back to you. And then, because I know both of you, I know both of you a little bit personally, so I understand both of you are great marketers, and you can't take that away. If we want to use your personal attributes, your, you know, that this area is where you are very good at. Dan, we look at the UFC, we have the WWE, we look at other things that maybe wrestlers will go over there and get it done. In Nigeria, there used to be a time, like I said, when we have Power Mike, Mike Bamidele, Power Uti, a lot of them, you know, we're also wrestling because it was WWE coming down here. I mean, are you people looking beyond the amateur wrestling to say, fine, entertainment, you can make it, because you don't have the advantage that football has, where everybody, mass, you don't need to advertise football before we play football, that to get mass participation, mass interest, that you cannot build up, who cannot pay to watch events at that level, entertainment level. Is it possible, Dan?
Well, I think it's going to be gradual. We're looking at a model in Germany where we have a club system, and it is semi-professional. I went to Germany for just one season. 1998, well, not even a season, about half a season, but because we kind of conflicted with some of my competitions and sponsor demands, I had to hold back. But we have to look at the system where we can have a league structure in wrestling in Nigeria. Like Okenwa said, if we've generated enough interest and we can have people investing in it and willing to own clubs. The Indian Professional League was in session for about two seasons, yeah. And right now it's a bit off because the UWW and the Indian League and sponsors and a lot of things didn't gel well. So that has not taken place. But back to the crux of what you were saying, wrestling is not peculiar. If you look at other contact sports, apart from boxing, taekwondo, judo, karate, outside of the amateur Olympic level of it, there is no professional angle. The professional wrestling we're talking about is not really wrestling. Is that thing?
Exactly.
Wrestling, we don't box people, we don't bring chairs in, and we don't act, you know. So, though successful wrestlers, Kurt Angle was an Olympic champion and did very well. And yeah. After 2000, I was heavily recruited to go into the WWE, as it was called then.
Wow.
WWF, I think.
Yes.
Yes. But I turned it down because I was told I would have to put on some weight, and obviously you know what that means. Those people are not tested. A lot of things happen with them. So I don't even really want to get into them.
Okay.
But I think what we can do is have athletes harness a lot from using wrestling to get into school, to be able to build themselves up to become very successful people in the future, like we have become. I used wrestling to go to university. I didn't pay a dime. A lot of my colleagues in school owed $30,000, $40,000. I didn't pay a dime because I was a wrestler. And it's the same with a lot of other people. But in Nigeria, we even have an advantage because unlike a lot of other countries where athletes are not employed to wrestle or to play soccer or to do judo. In Nigeria, we have a system in the sports councils where athletes are employed. So if you're using the educational advantage with it, before you know you become a director of sports, we have had about three directors of sports who were wrestlers in Nigeria. We've had permanent secretary.
Okay.
And before you know, we're going to have governors who are wrestlers.
Of course.
Those are the those are the kind of things. But I think to solve that problem, we must look at the league system so athletes can earn something that they can live on.
Okay. We are still going to come to you. Maybe probably after we'll go on a very short break, and we'll come back on a break, and we'll round the discussion off. Augustus is in the house, so he will stay with us till the end of the show. You are going nowhere. Augustus, you had him, putting the league. You say you wanted to ask, you have a question. Was it for Igali?
Okay, so before Daniel goes on, before we go on that
short break. All right, we just want to go, we just have to go on a short break. When we come back, Daniel is still right there in Wienegoa, and Augustus is in the house. You stay with us. Okay, you welcome back, and I know Dan watched that too. Dan, you are aspiring. I remember when we were rating the boards in the past 4 years, and we're thinking, should you come back or who should come back? Of course, we're a bit partisan when it comes to you. We are partisan because when people achieve, it draws up to them. I would say it is very visible. It is not propaganda. It is not what you want to say. People are looking at it. Where is this dream? Why do you want to do this?
Well, I think it's important that we have a number of our sports administrators at the decision-making levels internationally. It will interest you to know that we have between 26 and 28 sporting federations at Olympic sports. And in Africa, we don't have one Nigerian that is a continental president. Not one. Is mostly owned by the South Africans and the North Africans, the Arabs. And that is sad. If even at the level of Africa, we don't have a continental president, then what do we even say about the international level? And that's why I want to get into the bureau. Currently, we don't have any black person on the bureau. In fact, we've never had a black person on the bureau. We currently have a Moroccan who is also the continental president. And as a continental president, you have a right to sit on the bureau and vote. You have one vote. But he wants to also be the continental president and the bureau member with just one vote. Being two does not give you two votes. You just have one vote. And I think that's unacceptable, so I am contesting.
And of course, I don't want to ask an obvious question. How do you see your chances?
I think my chances are good. The whole world has to vote, but your member nations in Africa are very critical. So we're trying to ensure that we mobilize about 30 countries from Africa to go. Obviously, Canada, the US, and a lot of North American countries that I'm very close to are there. France is supportive. Russia is supportive. So we've been making a lot of our contacts, and there's sizable support. But I've also met with the Minister of Sports, who is very enthusiastic to ensure that at the international level, Nigeria also lends their voice to the support for my candidacy.
Okay, before we let you go, okay, you want to ask? Okay.
Dan, before you go. So for people who really don't follow wrestling, will you consider wrestling as an area where Nigeria has comparative advantage? If you look at the UK, for example, they allocate money to sport based on the achievement gotten from those sports, based on result. So would you consider boxing as an area where you think we have a comparative advantage and that we should make necessary investment in?
Definitely, I think we do. I don't know if I would say comparative advantage. I would say we've worked very hard and we've earned a position amongst sports that needs to be respected. If you look at from 2010, and before we came in, and that is not beating my chair, before we came in, we had a Bulgarian coach who had been here with us for 20 years. And with all due respect to him, he did very well for us. But we had not even won a bronze medal at the World Championships. From 2010 till now, we've won five world medals. We're on the verge of winning our first Olympic medal. We have dominated Africa from 2010 till now. At the Commonwealth Games, before we came in, we had won only one gold medal at the Commonwealth Games in 1994. Now, every Commonwealth Games we go, we win an average of three gold medals. So, if we talk about sport in Nigeria, I think wrestling is numero uno, and it needs to be given that deserved respect and sponsorship.
Okay, before we go, I know yourself and Caesar, both of you have been talking, and whatever you put discuss, they say whatever happened in Texas stays in Texas. But here we are in Lagos and we are in Egoa. He has a dream that he wants to put a gymnasium right there in the lorry, what advice? I know you have a gymnasium in Egoa, right? You have one. Have you finished that?
Yes, I have a personal one.
Personal gymnasium. I mean, how do you expect? How do you want him to go about it? Is it going to be task? How?
Advise
how tasking,
him.
How task?
He's already
is
complaining of
be?
The price of the mat.
He's talking about 8 million. The guy is shaking. So.
Well, I can tell him that if he wants a mat, I can sell him a mat for 6 million. I have four mats still. I'm taking off 2 million for you.
I'll sell you four.
I haven't said that. It's something that you need to work very hard to do. If you're not doing it individually, you need to work with different levels of government to be able to do it. We're building one in Yenagoa that we hope will serve not only Nigeria, but even also some of the West African countries. It's gotten to maybe about 40% completion, but you need to be able to work inside government. You need to be able to work with different levels of people, different funding initiatives to be able to get a wrestling mat done. But for training purposes, look at something small, something that will be able to just take one mat and be able to train first before you look at doing something major.
Okay. All right. Well, I think that Dan, it's been fun talking with you. He's still in the studio, so you can see when you program, follow us, and you can call in. When we open the lines, we can still hear from you. Thank you, Dan.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It's
all
been
right.
A pleasure.
Okay, that is Daniel Gali. Like we said, his resume is like this: he keeps on every day. He keeps on piling it up. African champion, Commonwealth champion, Olympic gold medalist. I mean, you can't do that. The highest, that is the apogee, that is the height, that is the zenith that you can get to in your profession. So, and then he came back home. That was he won the gold for Canada, where that is his second home. When he said he had the support of Canada, where moved to House of Over Canada. You are an icon in Canada. And then, you know, back home here, he was member of Bayelsa State House of Assembly and then, you know, president of Nigerian Wrestling Federation and a two-time commissioner for sport. Currently, he's doing his second tenure, like we said, he's back-to-back. And then he wants to go over there and say, let us, Africa has a voice right there at the top. And we think he deserves it. Here we get there on merit, not because he's an African, but because whatever color that his skin is, I think what he has done is enough to put him there. Okay? Maybe you also consult us when you want to put your mat. Okay.
Since I've used you to get a big discount.
A big discount, yes. $2 million is a lot of money.
He has given you a discount. I just very prepared to do that. Okay, let's come down. He says, today we're talking, the lines will soon be open. We're talking transfers. We're talking Champions League group. We are talking... the French Open, they are all here. But let us just look at where do we start from. Let us take some of the football league results that happened probably in England because the time is against us. The lines will be open shortly. You'll be part of it as the discussion is going on because this took, we need to do this for wrestling. And that is why we are doing what we are doing. That's why we dragged him down from Ilori and that's why we went to Yenagoa to speak with him. So those are the results, Yemi.
Okay, Chelsea have tampering the Crystal Palace.
Are they back after? Are they gelling now?
It's still early days. They're getting on it gradually, so this is reassuring for Lampard, and I think they can build on this.
Okay.
Everton, yes, they are in the form of their life now.
Four wins?
Four, exactly.
Each goal represents one win?
Absolutely.
Defeating, 4-4.
Brighton, 4-0.
Yeah.
Leeds United securing that all-important one.
What's the problem with what? City? Is it the injuries? Is it whatever?
They have
only 13 fit players in the other one, but that's whatever. The players are coming back.
They played so well in the beginning of that particular match.
Yeah.
Don't forget the fact that they lost to Leicester 2-5 in the previous week. And people were like, oh, they're coming up against Leeds. And don't forget, the person, the gaffer of Leeds, Bielsa, is...
His mentor.
His mentor.
He traveled to...
Exactly.
He left Europe. Went to South America to go and talk to Bielsa. I'm telling you, before he became a coach.
He's a man who he has a lot of respect for. And that match never at the door moment. And Leeds getting that 1 point. Newcastle, very much on the ascendancy to defeating Burnley by 3-1.
Okay. All right.
And today, Leicester City will be hosting West Ham United. Southampton will play host to West Bromwich Albion. Arsenal will also be at home to Sheffield. Sheffield, they don't have a point on the board just yet. Fulham will be the guest of Wolverhampton. And I know that Tottenham been put by Mario.
He's back to Old Trafford.
He's back to Old Trafford,
yeah.
Where we take on Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. They've been taking some jibes at each other during the week. Let's see how that pans out. Aston Villa will be at home to Liverpool.
All right. So those are the things. And then, okay, this is Spain, the results.
Real Valladolid lost at home to Eibar by 1-2. Atletico Madrid.
Back-to-back. Barren draws.
Barren draws against Villarreal. Elche and Huesca also played out a goalless draw. Real Sociedad defeated
Getafe
3-0. And Valencia lost at home to Real Betis 2-0.
Okay, let's look at the fixtures for today.
And for today, Osasuna will play host to Celta Vigo. Atletico Bilbao will host Deportivo Alaves. Levante will play host to Real Madrid. Cadiz.
Yeah.
Will play host to
Granada.
While Barcelona will play host to Sevilla.
Barcelona, they're going for 3 wins. I don't know. They want to go for 3 wins in a row. Those are the results right there. Fiorentina losing to Sampdoria.
Sampdoria, Sassuolo, they're defeating
Crotone.
Crotone, 4-0.
And Udinese
losing 1-0 at home against Roma.
And today,
Genoa will take on Torino. Atalanta will play host to Cagliari. Bologna will be the guest
Benevento.
Benevento, yes.
Yeah.
Lazio will play host to Inter. And then...
All right. Yeah, that is Parma. Parma taking
exactly.
on the Hellas,
taking
Hellas
on Verona. Verona.
All right. Okay, still in Italy, we have Milan taking
AC
on
Milan,
Spezia.
Spezia and Juventus.
And you've been taking
exactly. Napoli.
Napoli.
That Osimhen.
Osimhen, last time they scored six, you know, he gave an assist.
We
put it backhill. Let's see what is going to happen also.
Whether I'll be able to get the first Serie A.
In Germany, yes.
Union Berlin defeated Mainz by 4-0. Borussia Dortmund defeating
Freiburg
by also 4-0. Frankfurt defeated Hoffenheim by 2-1.
And
Mönchengladbach won away. Exactly. Cologne, 3-1. Stuttgart and Bayern Leverkusen played out a 1-1 draw. Werder Bremen defeated Arminia Bielefeld by 1-0. And Lübeck, exactly, won 4-0 against Schalke 04.
All right, today.
Today, Wolfsburg will play host to Wolfsburg, and Bayern Munich will take on Hertha Berlin.
All right. So, I mean, that is it. And then let us briefly, if we can take on the Champions League groups so that we can now we open the lines and then, you know, still hit at Caesar, who is with us here. Because I don't know. Some people say in Nigeria, we use... I like using Nigerian way balance because they said, you know, Ojuru, I don't know how that can be. Now, FIFA, UEFA want this thing done. That is why they put Barcelona and Juve because they want Ronaldo to play Messi. And they would have met themselves. But even meeting in the same group, they can still meet after us. If the Champions League draws are out, we can also take that. And then... why we move on all that discussion. Why we are waiting for us to get all those things done, I'm going to also talk about the French Open tennis. Let me ask you this before maybe I will join. Have you ever considered, I drew a list. Probably you can take a list. And then Daniel, I would have asked Daniel, but Daniel is still watching. I know he's watching. Who is the greatest wrestler that Nigeria has ever had? I have Power Mike. I have Bam Dele. I have Powawuti. I have Daniel Igale.
Let me save you all that trouble.
Okay.
It's Daniel Igale.
You didn't ask professionally?
No.
I will
explain to you.
Okay.
When you talk of wrestling,
yes,
it's basically Greco-Roman and freestyle.
Okay.
Right. Entertainment wrestling, yes. You know, but it's an all-comers affair.
Okay.
When you talk of point scoring, the Commonwealth or the Olympics, you should judge from that level.
Okay.
But aside that, if you were to look at the entertainment end of it,
yes,
then we should be looking at
Power Mike.
And we have somebody in Kwara. Like the African Tiger.
Yeah. Oh, no, go on. Yeah. No. I'm not holding you on that. And we also have
Mike Bamidele.
Mike Bamidele, killing me one too.
So we also have Giant Ajaloko.
Yes.
Who was heavyweight wrestler for 15 years.
Yeah.
And incidentally, he's the technical consultant to the Kwara State Wrestling
Association. Wow. So you have a book I inspire.
Exactly.
Oh, yes.
That is exactly what I'm talking about here.
From the very top.
Yes. Okay.
You know, from the Federation President Gali down. Also know that for you to grow, you must take cognizance of what you see around you. And then try to, you know, marry it into your own plans. The state government has set a plan for the growth of all sports, right? Particularly with wrestling, we've also tried to add those developmental needs, you know, that we know will be critical for its growth into the major plan.
How many local government do you have in Kwara?
15. And then we have 5 in Ilorin Emirates.
Do you have plans to take wrestling to the schools? I mean,
oh, obviously that's
Do you have plans that they can imbibe bit from that?
We've already rolled it out. That is the major fulcrum of a developmental program.
Okay. So you can have this wrestling school, wrestling festival, school championship.
Of course, it's COVID that has limited rollout.
Okay.
For this year.
But that is the major fulcrum of our plan. And I also know that, like I told you, those three major areas we've identified that we're going to work on, equipment and facilities, diet and health. It is those school
insurance,
kids.
Insurance, plus insurance, like you said.
Insurance, yes, that's health and insurance. Insurance, yeah. It is those school kids that will benefit.
Okay.
The growth of a wrestler, a kid wrestler from, say, 9, 10 to 21 is critical. Okay. So if we don't have put that, as a major plank for our programs, then there's a big.
But I want to ask you this. I mean, maybe I want to ask him this question because definitely health wise, they said you don't have to eat more than 2 eggs a day and stuff like that. Mm. But I see weightlifters, I see wrestlers, what they eat 20, 30, you eat all the. I mean, I don't understand. How does it go to their system?
But the issue is they burn it.
Okay. They burn it.
They burn it. Yes, every day.
Is that why they can eat more? That they can eat more than what is recommended medically?
No. See, let us.
Okay, no. Sorry, I don't want to cut you off. I was asking the question, but want to open the line so you can be part of this discussion. Like we said, a lot of these things are things where you follow the ongoing right there at the French Open. Like we said, at the transfers, Suarez is a shock to me because he moved over to Atletico Madrid. I think that is his DNA. You look at him, and to me, you look at him and Diego Simeone, Diego Costa. I tell you, they have a lot of fighters over there. When you are playing them, they should be ready. Barcelona, we thought they were going to go under, but right now, they scored about 7 goals, not conceding. How do you see that? Manchester United have been window shopping. They move from one place to the other, pricing Ferrari and Bugatti and whatever it is, from Sancho to whatever. And right now, they have ended up saying, okay, what do we bring in? Edison Cavani for about £200,000 a day.
A week,
£200,000 a week, and they're going to pay about €10 million to his agent. Of course, coming on a free, but nothing is free, even in freight, like we're told. So, these things are out. What is in the clubs? Which clubs are making whatever? Everton started on that flying start. Nobody saw Bayern losing, after going about 32 matches unbeaten at home. And what is panning out? But also Djokovic and Nadal. Will they allow the young talks? Because those guys are not in any way look at anybody's faces. What do you envisage? Because next week, we might not be here because of probably, I don't want to say anything yet, we may be or we may not, based on maybe what will happen in Ondo. So let us maximize today as much as we can. The lines are open. Join the conversation. Which players you want your club to get? Okay, you were talking about, feeding.
Yeah.
As part of the growth mindset, yeah, what you're creating.
Because of the economic climate, right? The best the association can do is to have those athletes that we've designated for this program have some bit of a measure of support in terms of their feeding and all over a period of time.
Okay.
At the end of the day,
are you able to sustain that? Is it through sponsorship? Is it basically from the state coffers?
No, see, government can't sponsor everything. Government can't fund everything. So what we're doing is we're reaching out to the corporate world, to support us individuals. And aside that, I have a well-loaded association in terms of personnel.
I'm surprised because like I said, yourself and Dan, you guys are marketers, basically that is what you are. Mm-hmm. And that is what you practiced a very long time ago. I can speak that for you. So when you were talking about, government, I expect that we probably more with the technocrats, more with the private enterprise, partnering, using the government, coming okay, fine to say what we are doing, has the backing of government, have a level playing field, have, a conducive atmosphere for you to thrive. And then those people can have confidence of putting, their money, and then the team you are building right there in Quara, that will probably Quara will have become after Bielsa and other places to become the synergy where a cynosure of eyes when it comes to wrestling.
See, I'm lucky. Okay. I have.
All right. Well, I think we have. Sorry okay, to cut you off. Okay, we have a caller right there in Lagos. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. Good afternoon.
Hello, Ken. How are you?
Fine.
That man in the middle from Quara State. I'm sure it's not from Kwara as per state of origin.
No, I don't think so. But it's a Nigerian Ekwaran.
You hear me?
Yes, yes. Can we up the volume a bit?
I'm sure it's not from Kwara State.
Okay.
It sounds like that of a demand from the eastern part of the country.
Okay.
Which is very good for Nigeria.
Thank you very much.
For our development. If a man from another state can come and become commissioner in Kwara State, which means we are progressing.
Yeah.
It's a very new development. It's a new dawn in our ways of thinking.
Exactly.
If Nigeria's government can do this, it's beneficial for everybody. I appreciate him. I want to give it to Igali, the best wrestler in Nigeria.
Yeah.
I'll give it to Igali because of his pedigree. There are people who are loyal to the government, and there are people who are loyal to the country. So the man did what none of them has been able to do for their country. He won a gold medal. And he's very, very intelligent. He's exposed.
Yeah.
I really appreciate him. I probably one day become the governor of Bayelsa State.
Hey, oh, hell no.
I appreciate him. I admire him.
Yeah.
I admire you. Ken.
Yeah.
Yeah, brilliant young man, too. You know, so I wanted to do something. I wanted to help us do something about Nigerian refugees who are not being invited for international tournaments. What are the reasons?
Okay.
Because they cannot speak French, or because they are not trusted all over the continent. I'm worried about that. I've raised this issue before, and I wanted to make it as a topic for your program.
Okay.
Because Nigerian wrestlers, Nigerian referees, I don't know why they are not being invited for international tournament. It's very shameful. I see countries like Liberia, like Congo, that have been invited for international tournament. No single Nigeria able to be a linesman. It's very embarrassing. And nobody is asking questions. Nobody is doing something about it. We are just looking at it as normal development. It's bad. It's shameful. That is it because of our corruption level that is being noticed all over the world? Somebody should please help and do something about it. I want to see our referees. There are brilliant ladies who referee in this our league. There are brilliant young men who have seen. I know the Lagos State chairman for the wrestling association, whether it's Nigeria now. I'm talking about Tade. It's my very
Tade Aziz.
About this case.
All right.
Nigerian referees to be seen.
All right.
They are playing in all international matches.
Okay.
I mean, they are not inferior. They are superior to most of these men who come from smaller countries.
All right. We want to go on a very short break. Sorry, probably you are called back after, or you hold on if you can, while we go on this break. And we'll come back as the discussion continues. All right, you're welcome back. I always say talking sport on Sunday, and that is your show, Channel Sport on Sunday. I want to put smiles on your faces. You want to follow us and talk with us.
Just to answer.
Yes.
You know, that's what Daniel mentioned. Talking about why we need to beware decisions are being made.
Definitely.
And that's one of the reasons.
Exactly. Thank you.
People will say,
yeah,
you are not there and you're asking, how was it shared?
How was it shared?
So that's why we have to play the sport politics. If we have people up there, and when they're nominating referees, when they're nominating those officials, at least somebody can speak.
You won't put for yourself.
So it's important for us to play the politics at the right level.
Yeah.
And that's one of the reasons why Nigeria needs to support
Danny Gali just said.
And not for just wrestling. For
all sports.
Is that 28 people there?
28 sports there. There is no Nigerian anywhere. Yeah. None. I mean, there used to be a time that we used to have Supreme Council for Sports in Africa. You understand? Odia and the rest of them all.
Abraham
Odia. We have a lot of persons up there who were, you know, looking out after
our interest.
But at a point, that is where this is also torn down. We have some representatives who went over there, and I'm sorry to use the word, they messed up the image of the country. I mean, and it became a representation of where you are. But this is a new breed of Nigerians saying we are doing things in a new way, and then this is what we want to fight for our right. You can't be deciding for us. We are partakers of this and equal partakers. And basically, I don't want to say it. So Daniel's bid and others of his life should come up in every federation and go to Africa, go to FIFA, go to the world stage,
the IOC,
and represent us well. That's what we are saying. Talking about representing us well, let us take this story, the story break a few days back of the coach of Mamelodi Sundowns. His name is Pitso Mosimane, who just left resigned because he got a new job. I don't know. Normally, we don't. I would have been with my calculator here. You can press your calculator and let us know how it is. Because in Nigeria, of course, like we said, we all look at this. You're talking about comparative. We're talking about comparative advantage. Then you compare how much a coach earns in Nigeria and how much a coach for a Nigerian club. You understand? We're not talking about the players who are not being paid. But here is a coach living in South Africa. Like I talked about Sonny Okosun, OZD, even the music is weird. What about from Cape Town to Cairo, you know, Wule, whatever. Okay, I will have another caller on the line. Hello, Chinedu, how are you?
Good afternoon, Chinedu. How is work?
We are working here. How is your Sunday?
Hello, so how many players did Man? There are many players did Man you signed this recently.
Only Van de Beek so far.
Van de Beek, the guy that they brought in, the Dutch player, is the only signing now. They are still window shopping. They want to sign Sancho. They want to sign Dembele. We have heard that Edison Cavani, he left. He has already boarded the plane yesterday. I hope the plane has landed in Manchester.
Okay,
he
must come to
Man U,
I think.
Yes, I think he will sign. That is almost a done deal, Edison Cavani, because he's a free agent, actually. He has left PSG, so they only pay his agent about something in close to 10 million euros, and they are saying, okay, fine. He will collect about $200,000 or £200,000 per week or so. £200,000, that's a lot of money. But if you are not paying anything for his transfer, probably you can spread it.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Chinedu. So let us talk about Pitsone. Let us see, because when he got this job, they said, like, achieve. Okay. Here is his salary.
$120,000
a month. That's about $2.9 million for the 2 years
for
contract.
The 2 years.
Yeah.
So what,
if he wins CAF Champions League,
he's going to get $480,000. Any party wanting to terminate the contract will pay 6 months' salary.
So if they sack him tomorrow, he will collect $720,000
from Cape Town to Cairo. That's the story of Pitsoni.
That is the story. But to tell you how massive this story is, here is him being welcomed by Al Ahly, the team of African team of the century. You know, coincidentally, a lot of us we didn't also tell you this, that Augustus played football. Is he was a footballer. Well, I forget that he's also a wrestling. But here is the president. Here is the president of South Africa. Look at what he said. Yemi, can you take that?
Pitso will be missed as a force in the South African football, but his appointment by our continent flagship club strengthens the bonds of friendship between our two countries. That's coming from the South African president, Cyril Ramaphosa.
The story goes on.
It is also a recognition of the talent and capacity that resides within our own continent. I wish Pitso and his team well as they fly our flag and the flag of continental football with a club in whose success all Africans take pride. That's coming from Cyril Ramaphosa. You see, we always say it, sport never fails to inspire.
Yeah.
His story is a story of inspiration. If you put in the work, you will get recognized. And that is actually happening. They are likely going to pick a coach from...
He won five league titles in South Africa. He won the CAF. He won the Champions League. And he won the CAF Super Cup. And I tell you, and here is Al Ahly, which I think the last time they won this trophy was in 2013, 2017, 2018. All right, let's go right down there to Oshogbo. Hello,
Adedeji.
Deji, how are you? No, 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 no. Deji, please do call back. I want to hear what's happening from outside Lagos. It's so sweet as well. Our guys from Jos, Club, where this is happening, Port Harcourt, worry, where it is going on. Let's hear you. So that is a pitch to getting reward for hard work, getting recognition for what, like we said, Al Ahly is the team of the century, the best football club in Africa. And then they have a coach who, just like when Mourinho left Porto and went to Chelsea, everybody was after him. And then if they can spend, I tell you this, because $120,000, that is what it ends a month. You can run a Nigerian club.
The North African League is always almost at par with the league in Europe.
Yeah.
And that's and bringing it back home. And that's why we say we need to develop our league. So that the actors, talking about the players, the coaches, they can get the right exposure. They can get...
Yes.
I remember, was it not from here that Mamelodi Sundowns got Amadi Shuaibu?
Yes.
Those were, even as bad as we said the leagues were then, I think we still commanded that kind of respect in Africa. But now that you are running, you paused the league for the World Cup, you ran an abridged league, court case today, court case tomorrow.
You blame others for your
misfortune. You blame others for your own misfortune. So you've actually brought it down to the lowest MLM. And I think a lot needs to be done, actually, to revive our league.
I just want to add that this money you are seeing is not coming from government.
Not at all.
It is money earned by Al Ahly. It is not a state government budget or a federal. Government should do something. This is earned. That is professionalism. You don't run a professional club with the people's money. We keep on saying this. I mean, it is an aberration. It is a disservice to what they should be doing. We are looking at England, where they are asking the Premier League to take care of the lower league. They say you are earning enough, but here our Premier League is dependent on taxpayers' money to survive.
Absolutely.
And they are professionals. These clubs are professional clubs. So it makes no sense.
I think just as the previous caller bastardized the word young man by referring to you as a young man, I think we're bastardizing the word premiership.
Yes.
Professional.
Professionalism.
In the context of our league.
Okay. We hope that maybe wrestling will take over. Because if you look at the last All Africa games, you see the contribution of wrestling. You see the contribution of canoeing. You see the contribution. I mean,
the number of medals.
The number of medals they're bringing in compared to what football is bringing in. And we know if you don't bring us the medal, if you don't bring us the money, then you are a liability now.
Absolutely.
Okay. Last thing, Didier Drogba, the UEFA, we have talked about Ballon d'Or isn't taking place, but the UEFA, okay, these are our players of the year, and Didier Drogba is the winner of the UEFA President's Trophy. And I tell you, Augustus, this gladdens our heart.
It does. I also want to take you back to wrestling.
Yes.
You know, I've been very lucky with the crop of gentlemen that have agreed to work with me.
Okay.
You have Alex Goma, who is the MD of Grand Series and Oil Mills. Bola Salako, CEO of Silverbird Communications. Bayo Issa, who is the chief of staff to the association in Ilorin. Otumba Moody, Uwesi Kaidi Uwesi. Chief Olabi Koka. It's a star-studded team. Chief Bolariwa Daniel Omolulu, who is the Sobaloju of Jogaland. These are people who love the sport and want to give back. We have Kingsley Chibu, he's currently in the US, but he keeps bombarding us with ideas about how to grow the sport. So you find that Nigerians...
We're rounded up.
Yeah, Nigerians want the success of the sport, especially for us in Kwara State.
And when they see that the administrators are straightforward and truthful,
yes,
and
yes,
focused, yes, I think everybody is always willing to...
All right, let's take this final call from Port Harcourt. I hope we can. Hello.
Jonathan.
Hello, Joe.
Not Jonathan. Innocent. Innocent.
Innocent. Innocent. Innocent. At least his innocence on the line. He's very, very innocent. Let's hear you.
Yeah. Please, I'm a Man United fan. We are not happy from what is going on.
You are window shopping.
We have a way to talk to a good word, whatever. The people should do something. That man has put us in a lot of shock.
Oh, yeah, yeah, important call. Sharks, as Rivers United have signed a lot of players. So don't worry. If Man United is not signing, Rivers United is signing. All right, Innocent. I think Innocent is not happy that Man United is not signing. But no. Was Edison Cavani, like we said, yeah, he boarded the plane yesterday. He would have landed in Manchester. This is where I think we are going now.
Yes, good to go. I think the sky's the limit with your growth mindset and what you have set out to do for wrestling in Kwara. I love the way you are going, especially with respect to picking them from the secondary school, the grassroots. That is the only sustainable thing to do. And from here, we always also support with anything that we can.
Thank you. You've already done more. Done much.
I guess since that we're happy you are here, like you said, we wish you the best.
Thank you.
We'll try whatever we can. We key in. Channels is a grassroots organization.
Yeah, and I must say, the Channels Kids Cup.
Kids Cup.
Fantastic.
Yes, we do that with Channels Athletics Classic. We do
all that. Kwara won.
I was there. I had to be there.
You have to be there. All right. Now, I think that's what we want to call it for today. We hope that you have a joy-filled celebration. We wish you a very, very happy Sunday. I'm Ken Ochonogo. Stay blessed.